Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss the topic grouping of cells. Cell. What is a cell? You have already studied cell. It's the circuit symbol for cell. Cell is what? Cell is a source of EMF. It is a source of EMF. Cell is the entirety, it is the thing due to which current flows in the circuit. Its two ends, they are maintained at different potential. The longer line indicates positive terminal and negative terminal. Every cell has an EMF, electromotive force. You studied this EMF, the potential difference between the two electrodes of the cell in the open circuit is called EMF. And every cell has some internal resistance. There is some opposition always offered to the flow of current within the cell, and that is called internal resistance. So EMF, we use the symbol E for EMF, and internal resistance we use a small r for internal resistance of the cell. Now when these cells, they are connected in circuit, so they can be connected, they can be grouped in many ways. They can be grouped in series grouping of the cells. They can be grouped in parallel grouping, or they can be grouped in both series as well as parallel. That is called mixed grouping. So they can be connected in series, and large number of cells they can be further connected in parallel. That is called mixed grouping of the cell. So there are different ways of grouping the cells. Today we will be discussing the grouping of cells in series. Grouping of cells in series. So what happens when many cells they are connected in series? How does the current, how does the resistance, how does the other factors, they change? That is what we are going to discuss today, grouping of cells in series. So for that, let there be n cells, small n be the number of cells. Let there be n cells, each of EMF E and internal resistance R. Resistance small r connected in series with an external resistance capital R. That is like this. Let us say we have first cell, then second cell, then third cell, fourth cell, and so on. We have n cells. So these n cells, they are connected in series. Series connection means when connected in series, that means negative terminal of one is connected with positive of second, negative of first with positive of second, and so on. So that is series combination. Okay, so this way we have these n cells. Every cell has EMF E and every cell has internal resistance R, and the whole combination is connected across an external resistance of capital R. So we have n cells, small n number of cells. Every cell is having EMF E and every cell is having internal resistance R. They are connected in series across an external resistance capital R. The current will flow from positive towards negative terminal. So the current will flow in the circuit in this direction. So let I be the current flowing through the circuit. Let I be the current flowing through circuit. Now, we have to find out this value of I. So, what will be the value of I that we have to find out? For that, total EMF of all the cells in the circuit E, this cell has EMF E, this again has EMF E. So, the total EMF, when they are connected in series, the potentials they get added up. So, the total EMF in series will be E plus E plus E and so on up to N times. So, we have to add E N times. We have to add EMF of all the N cells. So, that will be equal to N into E. Total EMF of the circuit, total EMF that comes out to be N E. Total EMF is N into E. Now, every cell has internal resistance small r. Every cell has internal resistance small r. So, R, all these resistances, they are connected in series. So, total internal resistance of the cell, of all the cells. So, that will be, again, in series we add up the resistances. So, that will be R plus R plus R and so on up to N times. That is equal to N times small r. Got it? Now, these total resistance of all these cells is NR. And there is one more external resistance, capital R. So, total resistance of the circuit. All these cells, they are connected in series with this resistance. So, total resistance of the circuit. Total resistance of the circuit, that will be equal to NR plus capital R. The total resistance plus the external resistance. So, NR plus capital R. Okay. So, we can find out the current flowing through the circuit. So, how to find the current? Current flowing through the circuit, we know V is equal to IR, Ohm's law, I is equal to V upon R. Okay. So, total current I here will be equal to what? V is what? The total potential, that is the total EMF of the circuit divided by total resistance of the circuit. So, these two values, say this is equation 1, this was equation number 2. So, total EMF we have calculated, NE, we said this is equation 1. Total resistance of the circuit is equation 2, N small r, N into R plus capital R. So, total current I. So, using 1 and 2, using these two equations, using the value of total EMF and resistance, what do we get? I is equal to N E upon N R plus capital R. So, when N cells, they are connected in series, the total current flowing through the circuit is given as N E upon N R plus capital R. So, current depends upon how many cells are connected, what is EMF of each cell, what is the internal resistance of each cell, and what is the external resistance connected in the circuit. Now, there are two cases pertaining to this. So, two cases. First one, when small r is very, very small as compared to capital R, or we say internal resistance of cell is small. So, what happens when internal resistance of cell is small compared to external resistance. So small r is very very small as compared to capital R. So in that case, since small r is small, R is small, so its value is very small. Its value is so small that we can approximate this to be nearly equal to 0, and we can neglect this. I will be equal to Ne upon R. Nr will be small as compared to capital R, so we neglect this term Nr, and I comes out to be Ne upon R, that is N times E upon R. I in that case will be equal to N times E upon R. Okay. Second case is, what happens when internal resistance of cell is large compared to external resistance? So when the resistance we have connected from outside, that is very small, what happens in that case? That is, R is greater than capital R. R is greater than capital R. So in that case, again from this equation number 3, what do we get? I is equal to Ne. Now capital R is small, so we can neglect this value. R is large, R is being added n times, and R is very large as compared to capital R. So we can, n small r is large. So what we can do is, we can neglect this value capital R. What do we get? Ne upon n into small r. N and n cancels out. What do we get? I is equal to E upon R. So I is equal to E upon small r. This is the value of current when the internal resistance of cell is very large as compared to external resistance. Now this is what? E, EMF of one cell divided by internal resistance of one cell. This is equal to the total current. In this case, the total current is equal to the current due to a single cell. And you can see equation number 4. Here, the total current is equal to what? Total current is equal to N multiplied by EMF upon resistance, that is current due to single cell. That means when N cells they are connected in series, the combination is useful. In this case, we are getting the total current N times the current due to single cell. And in this case, we have connected N cells, but the total current is just equal to current due to a single cell. So, thus, grouping of cells in series, which is the favorable case to connect cells in series? So, this one is the favorable case. Grouping of cells in series is useful when internal resistance of cells is small compared to the external resistance. So when we connect the cells in series, the total current is different. Total current comes out to be this according to question number 3. But how much useful this is depends upon how much is the value of small r compared to capital R. So, when small r is very less as compared to capital R, the total current. When the current due to, suppose current due to one cell is 1 ampere and we have connected 10 cells. So, in this case, we will be getting the total current equals to 10 ampere. But in this case, we connect 10 cells, still we will get the current equal to 1 ampere. So, grouping of cells is useful when internal resistance of cell is small compared to the external resistance in the circuit. I hope this is clear to you. Okay, thank you.